proper timing. Anyone who does not believe in shahada is kafir. If you don't believe in ashhadu an la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, kafir. A kafir is a kafir. I don't know what the problem is with that. For decades, I couldn't understand what the problem is. You don't believe in ashhadu an la. They call us kafir. You don't believe Jesus is the son of God. To them, they consider you an unbeliever, a kafir. It means he's not a believer. What's the problem if we say someone is a kafir? I'm not sure what the problem is. We have a kafir and a Muslim. Unlike what the deluded deceivers of this ummah today have been conveying. Allah in the Quran said, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ فَمِنْكُمْ كَافِرٌ وَمِنْكُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ خَلَقَكُمْ Creation. مِنْكُمْ كَافِرٌ وَمِنْكُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ There's only two categories. There's no third category. There's no third category. When anyone tells you there's a third category, know that he's either ignorant or he's corrupted in his aqidah, and most likely the second. Yes, he's a non-believer, he's a kafir. But you don't go to a non-Muslim or a Jew and you tell him you're a non-believer, even though non-believer, nothing's wrong with that. You don't believe in Islam. You say you're not a believer, you're not a believer, you're a kafir, you're a kafir. You don't do that. That's not the proper method of da'wah. Or you say, hey, come here, you kafir, I want to teach you Islam. That's not the proper way of da'wah. Yes, he's a kafir, but that's not the proper way of conveying da'wah, even though you don't bargain. He is a kafir. You have to believe that. He is a kafir. But when you convey the da'wah, you don't tell him that you're a kafir. There's no reason for that to tell him that. Sometimes, even people of innovation who are susceptible of learning and possibly coming back to the path, you should be lenient.